Welcome all of you at the webinar Site-Specific and Other Way of Making Shows. I'm Veronika Gallyas from Inspirál Circus Center, Hungary, Budapest. Beside that, the site-specific performance are always an interesting topic to talk about. We had another good reason to organize this event. We have a beautiful collaboration of four partners with the name Together. Our mission is to create two series of circus actions in two cities in 2023. We choose site-specific as a format of our shows. And fortunately, many of you will be there with us as an artist. First, we go to Elefsina, Greece, between 12th to 21st June. And then we arrive to Hungary and stay there between 16th to 23rd September. Each city is elected to be the European Capital of Culture for the year of 2023, which was definitely an important point why we are supported by the Creative Europe program. So thank you, Creative Europe, to invest in circus and for financing and supporting us. I would like to name the four partners of our collaboration: Monoki Closed Circus Rump from Greece, Kiev Circus Academy from Ukraine, Culture and Movement from France, and Inspirál Circus Center from Hungary. I invite you to check our website for more details, which is circustogether.eu, or you can visit our Facebook page, and also soon we try to catch you with some Instagram, and we try to engage you with TikTok challenges and interesting contents. Our presenter today is Albin, actor, director, and theater teacher of the circus school Lulido in Toulouse. The program of today, just as Bendegus said, has a maximum length of 2 hours. We start with the frontal part, and then we would like to continue with a more flexible part based on your questions. So I would like to ask you that during the presentation, type your questions and thoughts into the chat so that we can collect it and go through them after the frontal presentation. Don't hesitate to be active with that. And this part will be facilitated by Marianthi Mota from Makiklo. I wish you a pleasant 2 hours, and now I give the floor to Albin, the amazing presenter.
Under pressure. thank you. So, hello, everybody. I've prepared a wonderful PowerPoint presentation. This is my first time in life, so let's jump in it. Okay. Can share your music. And then normally it's okay for you. So, welcome everybody, site-specific, another way of making shows. So I've been already introduced, so this will be quite fast. Just because my name is not international, you can call me Alba, Albin, Albert, Alban. I accept anything, okay, it's not an issue. Just a small word about, yes, I've been teaching in Lido Circus School since 20 years now, and I'm working with the collective Culture en Mouvement to make site-specific show. We could call it custom-made show, which is also the name of the company I work with, which is in French, Compagnie Millimétrée, and in English, custom-made company, where we do a lot of site-specific show. Just for what will be next, right now, whatever you will see after that will be, all the pictures you will see, the photo you will see after that in the presentation are part of shows I've created. So if one of these pictures attracts you for any reason, feel free to write it down, and then after that we can also talk about that. And that was an election of presentation. I can talk about the things I know, I can't talk about the other things, so that will be more my vision than something different. Okay, and we have a plan. So we will first try to define site specific, which is a mission. Okay, Then, of course, we will have that philosophical question, really important. Why doing site-specific shows and not why doing other thing of shows? We have challenges to face, so we will address some of them because they are really important in that site-specific philosophy. Then I will try, with my experience, to share some ways of create site-specific shows, if I may. And then we will exchange, of course, a lot about that, I hope. What is a site-specific? Okay. So the first definition, I have stolen a definition, an official definition from the Tate Museum, which is a reference. So I let you the floor to read a little if you want. So site-specific, I just insist on the red words, work of art designed for a specific location. If removed from that location, it loses all a substantial part of its meaning. So as you see in the two examples, these are not from my shows, okay? These are examples from other installations, work of art. So the term site-specific is often used in relation to installation arts as in site-specific installation. We can also speak about the land art, okay? Which is one something also. So just if we are there, from that there's the first trick point is that site-specific, the official name is more a term for the work of art, from visual art than for living art. And that's a difference which can be important because when you are speaking about site-specific, for some people, they just see more land art of installation and the live part can be a little bit different, okay? A second point is that it's really not new, okay? The term site-specific has been invented in the 70s, but really before that, since prehistory certainly, all these site-specific shows are existing. We can quote Commedia dell'arte. There's a lot of street shows who can be site-specific shows. Not all of them, but some of them. So it's just important to have that in mind. Where it's new is that now, officially, in some countries, site-specific becomes contemporary. Where it was not art, now it becomes to be art. Okay, so that's the moment interesting for that site-specific show. And just facing all that, I just want really to insist on what I will share now is my truth, okay? Yes, site-specific, it's just a name. We can say custom-made shows. We could say other things, okay? This is a little bit different from street shows. It's a little bit different from other things. But once again, you can put whatever you want inside that, okay? And I've just put in on our shows because just what I said about the photos, whatever photo comes from shows we have created with my collective. Okay. So now I jump and I propose you to go on what is a site-specific show, just to add that sentence to be in that part of what I call my truth. Okay. And just before going, just to dive, because we are in a poetic world and it's important to have pictures, I propose you, with a wonderful technical manipulation, to share you a small video with examples. Okay, this is my loneliness moment. I jump onto the video and normally it will work so good. Thank you for up, and normally you got it. Oh, Okay. So normally, so that was just a small travel around really different mood of making site specifics. Okay. Yes, I hear someone. No, it's just a sound. Okay. So let's go back to my presentation. Oh, it works. So, and perhaps where I had the word show, where it's important is that when I speak about site specific, I speak about, wow, what a beautiful draw. I speak about that triangle, which for me is so important, which means, yes, on one part, there's the artist or the community of artists or whatever, the author, director, whatever. On the other part, there's the place, the site we want to invest. And for me, something really important is that third part, who are the people in charge of all the habitants or whoever are living or dealing with the site. And this changes a lot facing what we are doing, because of course, it's not just about invading a spot, it's about investing a spot. And the difference is quite important because we have to live with whatever does that. The most beautiful example is the museum, because there's a lot of issues and we all know that in the museum. I will come back later on that. So some few words about site specific, which are for me so important, which are relation. You enter at relation, not just with the site, but also with the people. So feel free to discover them. Discovery, second word. Agility, and we will go back later on that for the artists to shake ourselves, which is so important. And I will just insist on that these two words, yes and. We are here to find, yes, accept whatever happens, geography, architecture, whatever, and also what people want from that place. And then add our sensitivity as an artist, sensible. So that's this triangle, which for me is the base of whatever you can do in a site specific. Another thing which is really important is that site specific can have so many different scales. Okay, just to turn around this picture, you can see we can invade, of course, the first picture is the biggest one. It's a place, a giant place with big balloons and so on. So it was really how to invest a giant space. That's possible, of course, with a much more mediums, money and authorizations. But then we can also have small, more intimistic proposals, as I show in the other part with the cello, with the jugglers and the two dancers in the abbey. So different things. And the elephant, I've just added it because it's not just about people, artists, it's also about how to invest with whatever we can. And technique is also a part which can be invited into that. I was taking that example. When I say the triangle, these two pictures come from the same museum, which is the Musée des Augustins. It's a museum of fine arts of Toulouse. And that's really important when we speak about the meeting, because in the two pictures, it's more or less the same place, not the same room in the museum, but we invested all the museum. But in the first part, it was about make a poetic visit, investing the place to invite people into an artistic world. And on the second part, with the same people, they wanted to attract teenagers in the museum. So at that moment, the challenge wasn't the same. It was about how to make teenagers come into a museum. And the answer we picked up was, let's go into the fear, into the horror. And then in that part, we had another way of using circus, for example, contortionist, when you do ghosts or zombies are so useful on another way. So I don't take too much time, but it's just to show you these two different things. Just as example, I've just listed some different forms about making site specifics, okay? Of course, I've separated things. You can combine, you can mix. That's so, everything is possible. When I say tour, it's, for example, in a museum or wherever, or in a street or in a city, it's how to guide people from a point to the other, which means accept that the site is not just a venue, but it's an addition of spots. And then it's up to you to create a show that doesn't just investigate places, but also create the links and combine several possibilities. So that's an opening. Stroll, our live museum, it's also an opening, which means we can have our neighbor, the museum, with all these fine arts or visual arts. We can go there by being a little bit more as living work of art. And then we can invest sites and just propose as loop, as artist loop, being there and propose our material, but without a meeting, just being there and offering a different spot in resonance with the spaces, of course. The third one is the thematic show. So it will be more close to, you take a thematic which can be chosen with the habitants, the owners of the place, and then you go into that thematic. So that will influence the writing. Of course, you have to combine with the places, but that can provoke something different. Invasion, invested spot. This is also possible at one moment, just to admit it. The space, you can respect the space. You can also provocate a little bit, okay? I take the example of the museum. When we put the silk in the middle of the big stairs, as you saw in the picture, it was quite provocative because it was in the middle of the statue. It was something. Of course, we have to do that with the agreement of the people in the museum. But then we can also decide to push a little bit. And that's perhaps one of our role as an artist, trust and push. Performance, presences. We go more into the site-specific philosophy, the first one from the Tate Museum. We are there. We enter at resonance with a work of art, with a place, with a tree, with a house, with a drawing, with whatever you want. And then we go and we develop a presence facing that. Okay, in that kind of performance, when I say performance, it's because in a performance, there's not obviously a story. You don't go from the point A to the point B. You just be there, okay, and exist. And that can take quite a long time. Investigations or game. That's important to know, to name that, because in that contemporary world, the word game, for example, you all know the escape game or so on, are quite in mind of all the audience. And that's important to have that in mind. That's at that moment, how do I engage? How do I invite people? And then the last one, interactive show, which is another way to invite people. We all know that in street show, there's a lot of interactive potential. And even more in this kind of shows, site-specific show, you can also invite that. I go quite fast. Later on, if you have questions, we can develop, okay? It's just for you to have a tour. Where it's important, and just to conclude about all that, it's that whatever you do, think about the audience, okay? You will have and you will reach different audiences. And that's really important. When you are in a venue, people choose to come and see a show. They know that. When you are doing site-specific show, sometimes they know they will see something and they can't say it's a show because it's not a venue, but they come and see. It can be announced. And sometimes it's not announced. So sometimes it's really important to have tools which are not from our show world, but are tools coming from other world. And then the owners in my triangle, people who are living in the place, in the museum, for example, or in a castle or in a city, are really important because they know all that, okay? And perhaps even better than you. And that's an important part. Still people arriving, right. So before explaining a little bit, I have really a question, and that's important for me to share that. Why doing site-specific show? Because it's an election, okay? It's not a show like the others. Yes, there's a lot of things. We will face it with the challenges. So first of all, I would like to share you a tree because nature is always important. Bam, let's go. And we have Greek people, so we can play with these Greek words. Sorry, I play with the old meaning that I've catched from that. When we are sharing things, we are sharing things by three channels, okay? Logos, to begin with the trunk of the tree, the fact, analysis, reasoning, objectivity, okay? For example, if I take an artist will do circus. This is a fact. Or he will do dance or theater or music or whatever, okay? This is the fact. We are doing that. The pathos, which is more the relational intelligence. If the words logos, pathos, and ethos doesn't sound right for you, it's okay. Huh? It's just an example. But more relational intelligence, emotions, human connections, listening, and empathy. And it's more the how do you perceive the things? That means logos, I do circus. Pathos, and perhaps I do circus, and I do hand-to-hand or silk or something. And then pathos, it's more how you do that. Is it in a rock and roll way? Is it in a poetical way? Is it what inspires you? What reaches you? What is your aesthetic? And so on. Okay, and that's important because these two parts are the part we see. Okay, but then there's the third part, the roots of the tree. So important, we know that in that time of climatic changes, ethos. Which are the values, the credibility, the ethics, and the French word ethic, which remains important, twice written, and commitment. And these things are so important. Sometimes if you don't share your values with a person, even if you do the same thing, even if you are in the logos and pathos aligned, you won't follow that person. Speak about politics with someone, if he's not with you in your values, that will be really hard to go on. Then, why do I share that to you? It's because when you are doing, just to go there, I have the how, the what, and the why, just for you to have that. When you go into a site-specific show, sometimes you won't be able to do your circus as you usually do it. You won't be able to express you as a clown as you usually do it, because it's not the moment to laugh so much, or it's not the moment to talk so much. And sometimes, it's the logos is not totally yours. The pathos, or less, okay? You are used to put rock and roll music during your show. Not the moment in a museum, for example. Or it can be the moment, but it depends on how it was. But then you can ask the question, why? Why am I doing that? And that's a really important question, because sometimes as an artist, we are more moved by a big intention. We are more moved by, for example, for me, one of the things I really want in that, and I commit myself when I say that, it's I want people to go out from their houses. I don't want Netflix to win. So at that moment, I can use a lot of ways, and I can do a show with zombies or ghosts, for example, just to attract teenagers, because for me, it will be more important than my state of art, more important than even if I'm fond of poetry, I'm able to put the pathos apart just to go in the heart of what I'm looking for. And that's really important for me to share that if you do site specific, that can be a nightmare if you're not aligned with yourself, okay? I say okay, but I won't wait for any answers, sorry for that. Okay, so why doing site-specific show? There are artistic reasons, of course. That can be, of course, shake your state of the art, which is so exciting and important, okay? As you see in the picture, this agile and the bass, you can see the bass down on the floor. Yes, they will try to do different ways of doing circus in a museum, for example, but somewhere else. And that can be really important. Question your deep motivation on being an artist. That's what I was saying about the roots, about the why doing the things. Okay, we stay there. Ego versus values. This can be an important thing. At moments, you have worked so hard to be who you are on the stage. You are a powerful theater speaker, you're a powerful circus or a powerful dancer. But then you are, like in the picture, in the middle of a crowd because there's no stage, there's no light. And then it will be about, okay, what is important? And that's cool to do such a specific show. Once again, to shake that. Who am I? Who am I really as an artist? What is my deep node as an artist? Okay. And then the last one, and perhaps the most important, Perhaps it's time to consider in that world that art is everywhere at any time, and perhaps it's our role, if you do site-specific show, to put art wherever you can, whenever you can, however you can. And for that, perhaps be prepared to do so many different things than what you have worked on so hard to be who you are. Okay, wow. It's so crazy to be alone speaking. Please write down if you have reaction or questions. Okay, it's so important for me to have reactions or feedback. Okay, creator reasons. I separate artist and creator because sometimes as artists, we are just there to follow an author, a director, and in a site specific, perhaps we will be or directing or directed. And that's important to ask you the two questions. And as a creator, yes, that can be so exciting to write differently with constraints. Nothing to add about that. Ways of creation, okay, with outside demands. I insist on that. Sometimes you are in a museum, okay? Or, for example, Tatiana, you said to us at the beginning you wanted to go in a refugee camp to do clown, okay? Really great. And then, of course, you can go with who you are and with your creation. You can also first meet people or the inhabitants or the people in charge of that camp and obtain from them some demands. Because when I say demands, sometimes somebody will just say, for example, the museum, the ghost show, it was just about, we want teenagers to come. And that's all, okay? So we had freedom as soon as teenagers were coming. And that's really important to use that. Sharing and co-making things, that's also an important part. When you do that site specific, you will have to deal with everybody. When you are in dealing with the city, well, you will deal with the town hall. You will also deal with the technicals. You will also deal with the garbage traffic, with whoever, and of course, with the habitants. Somebody going through, you can't rehearse because they have to do the market and so on. So yes, it's about sharing. And that's the philosophy of the yes and. Instead of taking it on a bad way, how to catch it and use it, because it's like that. Site specific, it's like that. You have to adapt, like the zebra and the famous body painted artist. Once again, how to turn. So as a creator, it's, as I said previously, perhaps art is everywhere. If we want to affirm it, it's how to make anything becomes an art, poetry or fun. Okay, what do we want in life and how to turn whatever into that. Okay, I jump. Financial reason. Yes, it's also important. It's another way, okay? You can look for other venues. You can obtain other funds because there are places, cities, museums, castles, parks, whatever. They have small budgets. I don't say big budgets, sometimes yes, but they can have some budgets if they are motivated by the project. Another thing which is really important is that there's much more artists going out from schools and proposing shows now than 10 years before, okay? So that's also important. At one moment, there are not enough spaces to play, to perform. And then the last one, Europe. We are in a European project together that allows us to make that webinar, to make these two sessions in Greece and Hungary. So Europe can be also helpful. And there's a lot of European project about that right now. And finally, perhaps the most important that is audience reasons. Who comes and these shows? Of course, perhaps I speak just about France. I don't know in your country. I send back the question. But now in France, since the COVID crisis, we have in the venues, in the theater hall and so on, we have more people already convinced that it's cool to see shows. And we have less other people. Okay. I used to say that I would like my grandmother to come and see me, but she prefers television, for example. So how to invite them? Another reason is the goal, the messages. Do you want to put messages in creation? Who do you want to reach with these messages? How do you want to, yes, question the world? Of course, I don't know if an artist can change the world, but he can at least, or she can at least question it. That's for sure. And then who do you want to reach? The same thing. Okay, Challenges, water and challenges. Well, in the philosophical way, why not doing site-specific show? I told you it's a nightmare. It's important. Yes, of course. Nobody knows that they want you. That's really important. At the beginning, when you come and see this mummy, for example, was in a museum, that museum didn't know that they could do shows, okay? At that moment, it's up to you to take your pilgrim cape or clothes and go and explain and share and exchange, okay? And that's really important. But yes, at the beginning, you will have that for sure. Another thing is that, yes, we have no budget for that. At the beginning, they don't have budget. Once again, and I do that since 20 years now. Yes, at the beginning, they don't have budget because they don't trust you, because they don't know you. Okay. So it's not about organizing what you see in the picture on the first step. It's just little by little, do small things, convince them that it's a plus, because it's a plus, because we as artists are a plus in the society. And of course, they don't have budget because they don't think they have budget. But for sure, at points, some few things exist. Okay. And that's just, of course, I don't say it's a miracle. It's not a paradise. Now, today, it's easier for me. But then at the beginning, it was quite hard. It's just, yes, as a testimony, it's possible. Yes. Another thing really important is I will lose my artistic identity. Yes, sometimes when you do site-specific, you are apart. You are not on the venue, you don't have the good light, you have, as you see in the picture, yes, sometimes you will be lost in the crowd and what the hell am I doing here? Yes, that's a spot. But once again, I go back to the tree. What are your roots? And that's just the question, okay? If what you're doing there has a meaning for you, defend it, just that. And perhaps your artistic identity will become bigger. It's not usual duration and so much constraint. Yes, yes, yes. The formats are so different. Sometimes you have to perform right now without rehearse, without being prepared. That's right now. Okay. Sometimes, as you see in the picture, they did end-to-end during 3 hours, which is quite a marathon. But then they were prepared in another way. It was more a performance than a show. They were not performing and showing their best, they were saving their energy and they allowed them to go somewhere else. And once again, it's always the yes and yes, it's not the usual duration. Yes, there are so much constraints. And how do I deal with that? How do I get bigger as an artist with all that? My friend or peers will say it's not art. Yes, this is important. We are also a community. And sometimes it's not easy to change, okay, social control. So I just invite you to, instead of that, I just invite you to invite your community to consider and to enlarge what art is. Because, yes, art can be everywhere as soon as you do it quite well. And for example, that Spider-Man lost in the stairs was so amazing because all the night he had fun with people in a museum, which was quite amazing. It's a Roman, an antique Roman museum, and the link was quite cool. It's always different, not like a classical show. That's something really important. You can't copy-paste the show from a venue to another. And that's the definition of site-specific, which means that you will always have to be agile to adapt. And sometimes, if it's not your heart, if it's not your ethos, yes, perhaps you will get really tired and exhausted doing that. And finally, we can't rehearse. They say nothing is possible. Yeah, yeah, that's sure. We are, well, for example, in that picture, we were in a power plant of electricity, you know, water power plant to generate electricity. And they couldn't stop it. Because they were generating electricity and the sound was impossible to perform. But they want art. So we had just a small window to prepare the show just before, while they were cutting out the power. And yes, the artist on the silk was not totally ready. But then there was a presenter that invited audience, and they explained that to the audience. They make here the audience the sound that generates the power plant, and we played with all that. Yes, you can't rehearse, and sometimes you can't. There are too many crowds, there are too many things. It's up to us to adapt. Once again, it's not a venue, it's not a classical show, and that's really important to have that in mind. Okay, ways to create site-specific show. Thank you for the music. Thank you for the pause. That was perfect. So ways to create site-specific show. Of course, I would love to have a recipe that works. I just have, let's say, some tips from, it's more a testimony. It's more what we have done, because I'm not alone, of course, what we have done, and just some small things. The first, it's about daring or be lucky. Yes, once again, it's possible. When I say dare, I mean, that's what I was saying. As artists, we are legitimate, okay? But I know that for a lot of artists, we don't have that legitimacy. We ask for permission, okay? Or at the opposite, we invade too much, okay? It's about finding a balance, but sometimes just daring go into a museum. What I've done 20 years before in the Augustin Museum, it was a meeting and we proposed, okay, can we do circus in the museum? Can we do circus in the big stairs? And at the beginning it was, oh my God, not possible. Well, little by little it becomes possible. At the beginning, you will be the one to propose, of course. I've put in that picture on purpose. You see that picture, it's just all shoes under a statue, and that's already provocating something. Yes, at the beginning you won't have the trust, you won't have the money, you won't have whatever. It's up to you to be sensible and to find provocative small things going in the way of the museum. Of course, if I had put in a hat on the head of the statue, it would have been an invasion, because I would have touched the statue. So it's just about you to think about all that. And from the beginning, I speak about visual communication, emotional decision. That's important. We are all emotional. Even the safety guy from the city has his own passions and emotions. Okay, so listen and try to look and reach for that emotional. You can't say by the logos to someone, no. Nobody will say, yes, you're right. For example, when you say to someone, change your mind because blah, 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 nobody answers, yes, you're right. Okay. It's just because by the emotion that we enter sometimes. And good news, as artists, we know how to provocate emotion. So let's go there. Let's be ourselves, even in front of the officials. Okay. So be yourself, jump, go, and try. But then, try to exchange and understand people, okay? And that's really important. What are their goals? What do they want? What are their dreams? What are their values? Just that, I don't have nothing to ask. And just play with, not against. In that picture, for example, it's pretty provocative. It's in an old museum. We made something about Star Wars, yes, and you see the Darth Vader and so on, because their goal is just to remove all the dust from the perception of the museum. So we tried to find a way, and suddenly we perceive that the directress of the museum was totally fond of geek culture. She's really serious and so on. So if you don't go and push a little bit, you won't never obtain that information. But finally, she was there. So at that moment, it was how to open. But then it's not just about proposing a Star Wars thing. It's about proposing your art using the media Star Wars, which is something different. Another thing really important, it's explore the site, but it's written in site specific. Explore with the others. They will be able to give you examples. Read the history of the site. And take care, there are always two things, wherever you want, wherever you are. You are in the city, you will see the architecture. You will also see the contents, okay? How are the garbages? How are the habitants? Do you obtain watch, looks, smiles? Are you able to share? What will be the effort we'll have to do to reach them? Look for all the details, the hidden things, the small things you can have. And then, of course, put on your side the technicians, the safety people, and whoever. Ask to meet them to be sure that it will be possible from the beginning. If you want to put a rig thing at 10 meters high without having their go, they will say no just to have the power. Okay, so that's important too. Let them have their own power. Okay, so be with them. And just as an example, we put that curtain, for example, in that church because in the history, in the past, there were curtains between these columns to separate on behind. There were the abbeys and so on, so the religious people. And on that part, there was the public people. So public coming from outside. So when there was a ceremony, they were separated like that. So this idea comes really from someone telling us the story of that space. Then, after exploring, you meet people, you explore the place, and then be in conversation with your own vision, which is so important. What do you keep from exchanges and exploration? And please feel free to feel something like, oh my God, I see nothing, okay? Because sometimes you are in a dark room with nothing, with no soul, with no, okay, it's up to you to see that. And the less you see, the more free you are, which is a good news, okay? Because when people from inside have so many ideas, yes, it becomes harder to see things. Then listen to your inspirations. Good to have that in mind. Okay. Once again, you are an artist. Listen to yourself. It's not about killing yourself, to stay at the service of the thing. The trap is the main trap. For example, you are near a castle doing something. You have, the story of the castle in your mind, and then you become a tour guide, just saying the story of that castle. No, you're not a guide. You're an artist. So use that story. Pick up elements and go back to your universe. Listen to frustrations, constraints, and turn them into opportunities. Yes, and of course, if they say to you, you can't use your silk, well, they just mean you can't rig your silk. If you leave your silk on the ground or if you find another way, and it's up to you. And yes, you won't do whatever you have worked for it since 10 years now, perhaps, okay? It's up to you to find that frustration. But as soon as you enter at war against the place, it's not site-specific anymore. It's not an issue. Huh? You can do a big invasive street show or a big, it's something different. Let's say that site-specific, if you want people to be with you, you have to listen to them too. And then I just open to other artists. It's really important. Alone, for site specific, you're almost nothing, because sometimes it's the sensibility of your partner, your community. You will find answers in someone else's vision, and that's really a big point. Then, write, prepare, direct, and I just want to put two words. Okay, there's a major difference between augmenting and transforming. Okay, if we take the three pictures, for example, the first one, you see. We have put things above and under. I'm not sure of my word right now. Oh, sorry. Well, we didn't hide the object. That's my point. Okay. We just put a spot on the object so that you can notice the object. In the second one, we can't see, but there's a big painting just near the dead bodies, and it was just enlarging the painting. Okay, and in the third space, of course, you can see it, aerial show, without putting nothing, without black curtain, with whatever. So it's just augmenting and make the vision be more poetical, artistical, about the space, about the places, about the content, about whatever you want. Okay. And I've put in technique also, because in your community you have technicians, and sometimes you have the genius in your technique, which can just put you a small lamp in the face, and then suddenly everything becomes magical, as the red light on the side in the picture in the middle, for example. So feel free to think about simple things. Then manage differently your artist community. Yes, you can take so many different forms. We have seen a lot that artists will have to adapt. Okay. And sometimes, instead of turning them, instead of being a director, I'm director of shows or on real stages too. Okay. It's not the same work. Sometimes, instead of directing, you just pick up the right person with the right presence to be at the right spot. Okay, so listen to your sensitivity, okay? Because when you are about to perform 3 hours, sometimes you can't perform a role. It's better to be who you usually are, okay? So there's a thin thing then. Who am I to be able to perform that? There's questions about energy, about the content, about whatever. We can speak about that later, okay? It's just a list. We can share that all that if you want to keep it after. It's just all that you have to be conscious of, okay, at moments. You are just like doing a recipe, okay? You put a little bit of that, of that, of that. But sometimes you can't write, direct, and have exactly the picture you have in mind. You have to adapt all the time. And something, yeah, perhaps something quite important, and we are not so good at that, it's make it exist, before, during, and after. Yes, social media are so helpful, and perhaps sometimes we consider it's a loss of time, and I'm the first one considering that. I've been helped for that. Thank you, Marianthi and Veronika, for that. It's my first PowerPoint, for example, but it's important, because if you meet someone, as soon as you have pictures to show, as soon as you have video, as soon as you have things, yeah, that exists more. The same as partnership, okay? Feel free to be there. And perhaps something inside specifics is, if you're not the good artist to perform, feel free to share it with somebody else. Invite another artist, okay? That's part of the partnership. And inside specific, it's really important, because your show is unique. You change the spot, you change the show. So it's not about having habits about a place. And always consider the future, okay? I do movie, I make photos, I try to follow what I'm doing just for the future and the part. Well, thank you. I think I've taken quite a good time. Yeah, 9, perfect. I propose now to exchange. So I don't know if you have written questions. If you have written questions on your paper, I will just stop sharing right now.
Yes, there are some questions in the chat, and the first one is really technical, so I would like to ask it first. Then I give the word to Marianthi. That will you send this presentation in PDF or in some form? Are you planning to share with us the presentation?
Well, it's totally open source. Just I will need your help, Ben.
Yes, of course.
Because I don't know how to turn it into PDF, but I can do
it.
Yeah,
we will sort it out after that, yeah. And then we will send it to the participants. So it's open source, so it will work out. And then I give the word to Marianthi, because there are questions and you can host the Q&A.
Yes, so I'm starting with the first question coming from Tatiana or Tania, that she wants to know a bit more about investing. So what do you mean with investing in a site? Why investing? The economic invest return terms confuses me here, says Tatiana.
Yeah, sorry, it's in my English, certainly. Two things. Investigation.
Pas le mot français, peut-être.
Oh, that will be a loss for the others. Let's say that investigation, where it's important, just as artists, it's how do I emit the things? How do I be there? And how do I receive whatever happens? So it's, yes, there are ways of asking questions or being there, provocating a little bit. That means as soon as you are entering in touch with someone to create a site specific, it's already a play, okay? Not a play in a faking way. It's a play in a really honest way. I need to understand you. So I'm already an artist. Like if I was training with you, what do you want? How you are? I can be there, provocate, okay? I not just humbly at your service or too much there, because we are like that as artists, okay? So it's just about fishing a little bit more with energy, okay?
Then, yeah, we can move on to something different. And then if the question is, what skills an artist needs to have for being comfortable in a site-specific performance? And this comes from Veronica, but I think it's super interesting for everyone. So what skills / personality an artist needs to be in order to be comfortable in a site-specific performance?
Okay. Once again, my answers, okay? If any of you has other answers, feel free to share after. I don't have the truth. I just have my experience. What I can say is that if I am really caricatural, there are two big families of artists, okay? There are the artists, they are in this, in their own state of the art. They are creators and they don't need to be, how to say that, obsessed by the audience or by who will come and see me, or I am there to create and perhaps alone in my room or alone in my residency or whatever. And these artists are so important because sometimes they are creating new ways of doing the things because they are separating or killing the link with the audience. Okay, so they are not connected to the what does audience wait. Okay. The other family, it's what we could call more popular artists, okay? But popular in a good way, because for me, these two families are so important. I would love to consider myself as both, okay? I don't know. But then when we are in that popular way, we are more connected to who we are as an artist, facing the fact that someone and some people will receive that. So because they will receive, we have to consider the world around us, which means that for me, one of the skills which is the most important would be curiosity. Okay. And perhaps with that curiosity, there will be the word genuine curiosity, which means it's not because it's popular that it's not good. It's a tool. So I take that tool. And if it's useful for me, I take it. But then at the opposite, perhaps another really important skill would be to know a little bit more who you are. What do you want? I go back to the roots, which for me are the most important. What do I want in the world? And so if I know what I want, I can use whatever tool to express that. Okay. That's perhaps for the most important skills. The needs, I don't know, it depends on where you are, what you want to create, because you can just you alone with a small lamp create a show. So the needs will depend on the meetings, on what you want, or I don't have nothing to say more than that.
Okay, so yeah, we always keep it open, guys, to share ideas and thoughts yeah, about these questions, like about what do you think an artist needs, yeah, or like what skills, yeah, intentionality is needed, or also like how do you perceive this like investing and not invading in a site. What you can do is in the reactions part, raise hands, and then we know that someone wants to share something out there. So another really interesting question would be, what is not a site-specific performance? So we had this share, like what is site-specific, but then a question comes, what is not site-specific, which people sometimes think it is?
Yeah, thank you, because that's always the trap questions. So first of all, this question is so important, and on the other part, we don't care, okay? Because the most important thing is, what kind of show do you want to make, okay? And it's a site-specific show, let's go. It's not a site-specific show, who cares if it's the show, it's your best show ever. So, but then yes, just to go back in that family, we could say that there's a trap, which is create something and really want to reproduce it in several places. At that moment, it's not really a site-specific show. It's a perhaps it's a show for a museum, and there are many beautiful shows for a museum, okay? But then when you enter in a museum, do you adapt to the museum, or do the museum needs to adapt to you? And then there's a difference. In the street shows, for example, we have these two families in the street show. You have street shows, they are in the streets, but they need a stage, they need lights, they need sound, they need all the apparatus. It's not a site specific, even if it's a powerful street show. So it's not a problem, but it's not a site specific show. And you have other shows in the street who are, for example, all you know, this mobile show, they begin to point A, they travel and they adapt to whatever they cross. This is a site-specific show, of course. They are adapting all the time. They have a writing, and most of the time, this show, when they are well done, the people making this show will first explore the place to adapt their own thing. Okay, so yes, perhaps it's about that. If you do, and that's in the first definition I've put on, if the show is the same, it loses its essence. Okay, but then just to open it, sometimes because of a meeting, you create a site-specific show, which becomes a powerful show, and then you create a venue, a stage, to perform that previously site-specific one, and that becomes a show. So everything is possible, huh? Just to create vertigo. Whoa.
Okay. And then comes another nice question, like tricky one. So what would be the difference between improvisation and adaptation? Because you shared a lot about adapting and improvising. What is the difference between improvisation and adapting in this case? I don't know which case Tatiana refers to.
I get it, I think. Let's say that improvisation is an art and can be a performance, like clown, for example. Okay, clown can be an art of improvisation. Improvisation, you can make shows just by improvisating, okay, on a venue. Inside specific, improvisation can be a tool, okay? That means that, yes, you have planned, you have writing and written, and sometimes you just have to adapt because, yes, the present moment is the right. So at that moment, you enter at the philosophy of improvisation or clown or whatever, just to adapt. But perhaps the main difference for me is the writing, which is so important. When you have performed that triangle, you have met people, you have explored the places, then you have something. And normally it's up to you as an artist to create something. And then you write it down. Now, the level of writing depends. Sometimes you write everything and that's a performance really nice and really for the spot. Sometimes you just write the meetings, you pick up the right artists because you know they can improvise in your canvas, and then you let them do. So improvisation can be a tool in a site-specific show. But then if it's just an improv show, I love improv show, I do improv show, so I love that. But I won't put that in that site-specific family for that. I think there will be a writing. And for me, always important, perhaps it's one of the needs for the site-specific, always consider the audience. At one moment, the audience you will have is not just show audience. You will have audience from that site, habitants from that site, or I don't know, people who comes to see a combination, not just a show. And these habitants, the more it's written, the more they will feel that you have adapted yourself to the place. And that's something in a good site-specific show you can feel, okay? Even when there's a ghost, huh? If the ghost comes from the painting behind him, wow, there's something. If it's just a ghost because you have the dress of the ghost, well, no, it's not the same. So the more you adapt, the better you feel something and the more the audience is invited in that combination.
Thank you, Alban. I think for me is kind of important to say that if there are like really main things that you guys like want something to say it again or rephrase it in simpler words, just share it with us. I think Alban is more than happy to really like explain things. Francisco, you have a question? Yes, I saw you. Perfect. Do you think you can open your mic or Ben, if you can unmute Francisco? I don't know how it's done. Both ways, maybe.
Okay. Now you listen to me?
Yes, perfect.
Yeah, okay. Okay, thank you very much, Alban. It was very, very interesting. Your explanation and very, very clear. I just want to, I don't know if it's a question or is an observation. In practical, when you speak a lot about adapting this, adapting that, it's very, very important. But how is the line between adapting and to express yourself? How is the line to be adapted and be you too? How is the line of adapting but also creating? So I practical in this specific site, who do that? The director? There's a director, they say, okay, until here, until there. How this is kind of personality, because we have a personality. And we have an ego too. And we have people more mature and people not more mature and people in a level and other people, different levels of people and different people in this specific site. So how this move, because one thing is that to create, one thing is to be artist and to develop things. And also between, but you also have a personality, and you have also a level of conscience or a level of things. So how this move in a specific side by your experience? I don't know if I'd be clear with my observation.
Clear, and that's why exactly why I wanted to express the challenges of a site-specific show, is that you are not protected by the stage. You are exposed from the beginning as soon as you enter. And I told you about that trap, okay? You begin to have the story of the castle. Suddenly you become a guide and you want to tell the story of the castle and you lose your artistic identity. That's a major trap. So thank you, Francisco, for that. That's amazing. And I just can answer that, accept that you will not, you will not be perfect. Because yes, sometimes you go too far on one side and sometimes you close too much, okay? Sometimes you are there saying, okay, I want to, be myself. So I refuse to perform Star Wars in a museum, okay? Because that can be the answer. And on the other part, you say, yes, let's do Star Wars in the museum. And then you just have fun to be Darth Vader and you totally forget what you were supposed to talk about because Darth Vader is so fun. So yes, there's a trap about that. When I say, for me, the best answer is the community. As a community here, as soon as you obtain allies, my company, we are a collective. We are collective of creators and we are watching ourselves. And we dare sometimes to say, hey, what are you doing? Okay. Because yes, sometimes we get lost. Of course, that's the world where we live. Sometimes we are called by companies. So when it's Coca-Cola, it's easy to refuse. But sometimes it's not so easy to refuse because they have money. Huh? And sometimes we have to live with that. So how do you deal with that? Well, call your friends. Huh? And watch yourselves. Because, Francisco, I can just tell you, be prepared to all that, okay? And I go back to what I said previously. If you stay improvisating, perhaps you will fall in a lot of traps. If you write, once you have met people, once you have met the place, if you write, that allows you to have a shape, okay? And then I go back to another thing, which is really important. When you go to a site specific with several persons, please pick up the good ones. Okay. If I go back to the Star Wars or superhero example, the most provocative ones. Okay. Because we are more in the movie, big audience movie, American blockbuster than other things. But then it's to invite people to a museum, to tell them about story, to make combinations between Empire in Star Wars and Empire in the Roman Empire, for example. And there's a lot of beautiful things to tell. But it's up to you. It was my role to pick up the good artists, not the one just being there to having fun playing Dark Vador, but the one sensible enough to be there as a cliche of the role and able to, in that role, bam, to throw whatever we wanted to throw as messages, question, and information. Okay, so it's also something about the community, once again. But yes, it's a real, real big trap, of course, because you have to be agile and sometimes you get lost.
Thank you. Any other questions? So either by raising the hand like this or by raising the hand using the emoji. Let me see. So maybe I leave some time for thinking while I want to be provocative a little bit, and I would like to invite everyone to open your cameras. So it's time for the group picture. Yes, and yes. We are here creating an environment, and let's say, I mean, it might probably also be very wrong what I will say, and Alban might correct me, but let's have a moment of a site-specific, everyone in our sites, you know, doing something, picking something, pick something like, let's say, an object. Yeah, how about that? Maybe we come closer to our environment. So take a moment and look around. Yeah, what you have, like around, I don't know, maybe I'm thinking, I don't know, something from the office, because I'm in the office. Yeah, and then you pick up something or you choose something that you like in your space and be there to pause. And then we take the group picture, creating our own site-specific moments, you know, of creating a site-specific photograph. So whenever, Ben, you think everyone is ready, then we can go for it. Ben will give the shot.
Yes, 3, 2, 1, go! And actually a new question just arrived in the chat, so we can go back to the Q&A. Thank you.
So yes, a little bit of, I would call it a spoiler alert. So Nina is asking, can you share a little bit of your ideas of the site-specific show Greece project?
Oh, sorry, Albin, I accidentally muted you, but you can unmute yourself.
That was perfect. I didn't want to talk about that. Thank you, Ben. Wasn't prepared. What I can share in Greece is that we have made a first journey. So we have been there in Elefsinas just to visit all the spots and to do whatever we said on that webinar, which means be there in the streets, looking at all the spots, be curious, looking for hidden details. You can ask to Marianthi. She was full of information about that balcony. What do you think we can use it? And this thing and so on. So yes, we did that to explore and see all the possibilities. Then I have that first. Then we meet the officials there, which is also important, once again, to talk with the habitants, to see how it works there, to understand a little bit, okay? Because for me, it's really not my culture, so there's something even more complicated. But then there's something I can't work on for the moment, is that I spoke to you about the community. Normally, when I imagine a site-specific, then I begin to plan with the artists I know, or the artists I dream of and that I'm looking for. For the moment, I don't know you people. I don't know exactly in this webinar who will be there in Greece or who won't be. But then the first day will be so important to meet, to understand who do we deal with. And then after that, I will spend a night non-sleeping and just beginning to shake all that to have ideas and to receive proposals from you. So it's when I say it's about being agile, yes, it's that at one moment it's accept that you won't perhaps have the answer until the moment you have to have it, which is the 1 hour before. No, I exaggerate, but we planned a lot of things and then we will play with that. Yeah, that's what I can share for the moment. I really want to be honest with that. And also perhaps I can share that I want to share with you the process, which means that, yes, I want to be with you to discover. Let's get to know each other. Let's fall in the traps if possible. Perhaps we will do a street show and not a site-specific show for the first day. But it's okay. We have 5 shows to make in 8 days. So so easy. So, yes, a lot of challenges. And we will spend time to go there together. So, yes, that's what I want to share now. Just going back to the questions before, can you say memorable surprises, challenges you had to deal with? I just want to tell you one, because yes, that was quite amazing. But we performed in a park, in a garden of plants. I don't know the term in English. A garden when there's a lot of special trees, herbs, grass. So it's like a museum, a green museum. So we put a portico and we had planned that wonderful, pure poetic music. There was a flute and a guitar and we had silk. And the idea was to invite people to go lay down in the grass and listen to that. We didn't plan that at the beginning of the night, there was a frog concert. But when I say a frog concert, we had frogs everywhere in the garden, and the mood was just and that was not quite at all, that was totally and unpredictable, because I had visited the place but not at night, and nobody told me about the frogs, because for them it was normal. At that moment, yes, we had to improvise quite a lot. But then that was really nice. The two musicians began to enter in improvisation with the frog. They put rhythm with the frog, with the bap, 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 bap. And then we had epileptic silk using the rhythm of the frog, which was so cool. So yes, sometimes you can write, you can plan, and forget it when it happens. But that was so poetical with the frogs, because Once again, nature was the winner.
So I don't know if somehow the following question can be answered according to what you just shared, but out of an organizer's perspective comes a question from Mary. She's the organizer of FES Fringe Festival. So the first Fringe Festival happening in Thessaloniki in a few weeks from now. So how much time is needed for analyzing the site and creation, meaning the writing? How much time is needed?
The time you will give. I go back to what I said to the beginning. Site specific, it's more a philosophy than a contract. That means that at the beginning, you want to make a site specific show. Okay. If you have time to explore, yes, that will be so interesting because when you go to a spot, yes, Elefsinas, I'm so happy to have all the story about Demetra and Persephone and so on, because that gives me something. I don't know if I will use it, but I have the old Greek story. I have the story about the companies in Elefsina. So I have another element. I have seen the spots. I had time to explore the spots. We had time to see the officials. So all these times are, how to say that, gifts that can become tools to create something. The more time you have, the more possibilities you can explore. But then sometimes you just have a small spot to watch something and create. Perhaps it will be less site-specific show. Perhaps it will be just a show in a site and not so specific. But then, who knows? Okay, that means that the audience will come, even if there's just one resonance at one moment with one object there. This moment of resonance will be, oh, look at that. They use that thing. And that will be a gift. That will be a dedicated gift to that special site. And the philosophy is there. So you can't miss the resonance. You can just add resonances and you can add deepness in your analysis, writing, and so on. So once again, it depends. If you want something deep, take time. Yeah. And when I say take time, it's not 10 days. It's not necessary, but at least, to observe. Okay. Then there's to observe. Yes. One day and perhaps 1 hour at night to be sure that you don't have frogs for you. But when I say that, sorry, I just say that to not to laugh, but that's important. Sometimes you are somewhere. I will speak about two places, refugees camp, once again, because it's so important, and hospital. These are two spaces where when you go at night, suddenly it's, I don't know the word in English for glauque, you know, like a bad thing, really scary or really, that can be quite impressive. And sometimes you see it at night, it's a sunny day, it's cool. Okay, at night, it's not the same. So spooky. Sometimes...
It's spooky, the word you are looking for.
Thank you. Spooky. So, sometimes it's important to feel that, okay? Not to fall in the trap of being too positive in a place which is not so positive, okay? So, yeah, perhaps. But then once we have said that, it depends. This is the time of writing. Then... perhaps we didn't address the rehearsal time. It's always cool to have time to rehearse, but it's not always possible, okay? And that's also part of the process when you explore. If you don't have time to rehearse, my advice is to have some few times with your company or with your guys to prepare as much as possible the scenes, the meeting point, something to have something for sure. But yes, the more time you give, the better it is. Like for a classical show.
Thank you. So any other questions? Raised hands or anything? I'm just trying to get a hold of you guys. So I don't know if, Alban, you want to share something extra or...
I would like to share something because I really, it's a tricky point, okay? So I will share it with simple words, and please feel free to react once again. I know that sometimes in France, we are lucky for that special treatment of the actors, okay, in France. So that allows us to make creation, okay? And I know that. But then what I want to insist on the site specific is that it's a way of creation which can be done with some small things at the beginning. Okay, that's important. I don't know if you remember in the pictures, there was some pictures. It's just a musician, the cello, put on the first floor with a dancer down. Okay, two people. And wow, it was amazing. Okay, because yes, they were performing together. Okay, and we attract people with that. When I say that, it's that it's totally possible to begin to create big pictures with few people, okay? Our big dreams as artists don't need, from the beginning, big things, big money, big lights, and so on, okay? I go back to that, okay? It's a small light that exists, that's not expensive, and that allows you to create some effects, okay, and even contemporary effects, which is so important. I mean by that even with your phone, you can light something sometimes. It's because it's important. Sometimes we are stressed in a creation because we want a beautiful light, we want something, and so on. In a site specific, there's a power, is that the site is the scenery. And that site allows you to exist on a simpler way because it creates all the scenery around, okay? If I was talking to you in a museum, if behind me there was a statue or whatever, I won't have the same presence. And that's something you can use at one moment. You need less because the site is doing most of the job, okay? So be yourself in that. And that's really important at the beginning. Yeah, accept. Perhaps the first step won't be paid so much. And the second one will be, but take pictures, begin to exist. Okay. And as soon as you don't fight against the people, but with the people, you begin to have that trust. And then, wow, I go back to the Augustin Museum. I quote them as examples at the beginning because they were the first to trust me 15, 20 years ago. I don't remember. But then we still are working with them because as soon as we have the trust, now they have so many ideas. And one of the last was zombie attack with creation of masks for people because they had an exhibition of a painter who was really fond of, you know, strange skins and so on. So they made the link with zombies and we created a zombie apocalypse in a fine arts museum, which was so nice because the audience who were there were really not used to see shows. They were really not to see a museum, but they were there, okay? So there's a lot of possibility like that.
Thank you, Alban. We have an interesting question about the sites and the materials that we can use. It's coming from Gina. So since site-specific is primarily about the space itself, where could you define the limits of our intervention to a space as creators and performance? I'm not referring to the performative part, but to the material, constructions, open props, etc.
Well, without being provocative, because it's really what I think, your limit is your imagination. We will try to do that in Elefsina. I'm spoiling again, but one of the sites I've chosen is perhaps the worst site to perform a show. There's no space. But when I saw that, because I was thinking, oh my God, how can we do a show like that? I was thinking, okay, perhaps it's interesting because tac, 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 and let's try it. When I say that, the best example is in the city. In a city, you can, when I was speaking about the tour, for example, you can decide to make a show, which is a tour, to invest a window in that house because you had obtained the possibility to perform on the window. And then 200 meters after you have something different, and so on. We made a show. We invited people to jump into a bus, and then we were rolling to a place. But then, because it's a show, the bus is not just a travel. The bus is the opportunity to create another chapter. So chapter 1.A, chapter 2, the bus, chapter 3, the space where we arrived, okay? So limits, well, let's say that it's perhaps stay inspired by what you see, and then it's up to you to keep on making the links. And if we have several points, make the links between them. Build your story, build whatever you want, story or performance, or, okay, they're not obviously a story, but your poesy or whatever. I don't know if it answers your question.
I'm not sure, but I have one more question. Because I think that site-specific, as we said, it is about the space, like primarily, like it's the first thing. So is it okay when we make a site-specific show to change it so much, the space, so it kind of loses the identity it has? Like if we bring constructors and we change the lighting and I don't know.
I was saying that previously. There's a difference for me between the English word, sorry, augmenting and transforming. Okay. And yeah, in my vision, once again, in my vision, and once again, if you do the opposite, it's okay if it's not a site specific. But in my vision, as soon as you augment the place, you are in the site specific. As soon as you transform, you have not, obviously you are not outside, but you are in the trap of perhaps transforming too much. Okay. But once again, it will depend on what you are telling. Okay. Put a portico in a church, for example, is not transforming the space, because as soon as there's portico, everybody does that. And the philosophy of a church is that. Okay. That high. So, being aerial in a church is totally aligned with the church, okay? But if we are in an intimistic place and some few things, and you put a portico, yes, perhaps you are destroying the mood of the space. That's why I invite you first to feel the space. Be there, but it's the same in a venue. When you are in a stage, that's the best moment when there's no audience, you know, in the seats in front of you, you are there. And you are also feeling the stage, okay? And that's perhaps the thing. But once again, if you need to change the thing, change the thing. And just sorry for one thing, just before you say it's about the space, I go back to what I say. For me, it's about a meeting with the people, with the owners of the space, okay? That's really important. You can't just meet the space. You have also to meet the habitants. Let's go back to, you know, all city, when you change the politicians in the front of the city, something changed. When you change the director or directrice in a museum, it's not the same soul. It's not the same vision. Okay. If you don't obtain the vision, perhaps you will miss something. Okay.
Alban, I don't know if this is helpful, but I would like to share it. Since a lot of us are not native English speakers, I found very quickly this simple Google explanation. So augmenting, and I found it really interesting, is make something greater by adding to it, increase. And transforming is make a marked change in the form of nature or appearance of something. So I hope this is helpful for making like this distinction of augmenting and transforming in the terms of us being in a space. I just wanted to share.
Okay. Perhaps I can just go back to some small adding pictures for the different form. When I say tour, you see, for example, oh, it's me in the role. I'm not so old. For example, I was a guide in a tour when they were meeting in different things. But you see, I wasn't just a guide telling the story. I was making them shouting in a church just at the rebel act. It's a tour, and it's just two of the stories. Performance and presences. For example, you see on that picture, they are just there on the balcony in the street. But I don't know if you see in the mirror down, everybody is just looking. Nothing happens. Huh? They are just there on the performance and they hold as long as they can. Everybody stays until one is remaining. And that's crazy. That's just a picture, but that works. On the other part, yes, it was an aerial on a glue that was quite impressive. And we are in a presence. And then everybody is more in the, let's say, fright, fear and whatever, but also poetry, because a lot of things were happening about that. And she was almost not moving because of the high, of course, but a lot of things were going through. Stroll, live museum, just an example. You see, for example, a contortionist just there, creating a resonance. We had the blue tape on the ground, we had the blue tape on her, and we just let them express and be alive in front of the poster. And there were like 10 artists in that museum doing the same. But people, they were strolling, which means they were walking and visiting the museum as they wanted. It wasn't a tour guide. It wasn't a time dedicated show. It was, we will stay there for 2 hours, take the time you want and stay as long as you want with the artist. They will be there in a yoga style to hold and keep the mood, but they were there like that. Those thematic shows. So I told you about the zombies. Here is the picture that was so cool, so funny. And we had a guide, he was an actor, but he was actually, he had just been beaten. I don't know if you're familiar with the zombies. When you are beaten, you have maybe 10 minutes to live maximum. So he had 10 minutes to speak about the exhibition. And then after that, he was running after the visitors. So he explained, he was the friend in way. He was explaining during 10 minutes after he became the enemy. And the visit was so funny just because of that. And we, of course, enjoyed the time to say a lot of things about the history of the painter and the paintings. And on the other side, it's a dialogue in... there are runes of old Roman history. So there we had the permission, unlike Elefsina, to perform in the runes. So we had a dead Roman body and we were performing a dance with that. Invasion, invested spot, which just to illustrate, yes, sometimes you can just see the small details, a wall, a rune, and oh, suddenly we can have the picture. So you see, and that can make the point. And then just after that, they were doing their circus number because they are circus artists. And that was quite well because they were just doing what they know how to do. And we just had another way of entering in or leaving off the number. Investigation game. So the same, you can put a picture, you can invite people to be there on another way. We spoke about that. It's just an illustration. And the interactive show, I will insist on that part, and especially with kids, for example, and that can be a value you can ask, how are the kids for you as an artist? Because it depends. We can't share. We have everybody has an opinion. But as soon as we invite, and then it was the case, I invited the kids to be part of the process. They had to hide by being on the ground. But then I was with the kids in front of the parents so that the parents participate too. And then it becomes quite good because all the kids are your allies to invite the parents to go on the floor, which is quite strange in a museum. And that's all. Ah, no, and just that, it's a link I wanted to make. Social sculpture. I don't know how to share that, but that's important. That's a movement. I don't know if you're familiar with Joseph Beuys, I don't know how to say it in English. He's one of the founders of that, but social culture is more a movement which considers that art is here to change the world and to be part of social movement and so on. And that's also a question about your values. As an artist, what is your goal? Change the world, question the world, just have fun, enjoy. And what is the best? Your own election. And that's all.
Albin, we would like to thank you very much, and we would also like to thank all of you that you have been here. Feel free to react. We see some hearts, and I don't know, like what else, if you people have the energy. I think it's time to say good night. Yeah, we see some improvisation of people like expressing their big hearts are coming, and small hearts,
right,
and clappings. Very nice. We really hope this was inspiring for you guys, and we will have this webinar post it on the YouTube channels of Monokiklo and of Inspiral. And also you can follow the pages of Together Circus that you will find in Instagram, Facebook, and on TikTok. Because hopefully this for us was the first invitation. So Together is a circus invitation, but one part of it is the digital invitation. So this was the first part of the digital invitation. Thank you all for being here. More digital invitations are coming through the social media, so that we want to keep inspiring each other in this world that is called like the site-specific shows. And within this world, all of us to keep on being inspired, even though we are away. So that, you know, we keep on finding our whys and hows and whats about making shows. I don't know if Veronica or Ben, you want to say something? And that is for me.
Thank you very much, Marianthi. I am fascinated that you mentioned Josef Beuys, because I am a big fan of him. And I just... if you're not familiar with his personality, I just sent in the chat an interesting article in Wikipedia about one of his performances. And Beuys is a really good example, because he started art at the age of 40. So when we are dealing with this kind of site-specific switch to site-specific thinking, it's never too late. And Beuys is a really good example for that, because he started to act and be an artist, and then even be a politician with his artistic way of view of society. That's a huge deal. And if you really want inspiration about how to deal with art and how to change the way of thinking with art, Beuys is one of the best examples for that. Thank you very much.
Okay. Just as an invitation, because it's important, as soon as I know how to make a PDF with my presentation, I send it to you, or I send it to Ben and he send it to you, because I don't know how to do that. Because I'm old, I'm on Facebook. If you try to look for me on Instagram, good luck. I'm also open to exchange about that. Okay, so feel free. Right.
Thank you very much, everyone. Have a good night rest with lots of dreams about site-specific shows. See you soon, either in person or on social media. Thanks a lot, everyone. Good night.
Bye-bye.